Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question from Sergio in Mexico. Sergio says, I have two columns, names in column A, colors in column B. I want to figure out how many times each name occurs with each color. Three ways to do this. We're going to talk about all three today. First one, insert, pivot table. I want to go to an existing location. We'll just move it out to the right-hand side here. Click OK. All right, so we're going to put name down the left-hand side, color going across the top, and then color in the sum values. And that forces Excel to count because it's text. It doesn't know what else to do. So that's a quick way to solve the problem. If you're in Excel 2007, we can do this with a brand new function, new to Excel 2007, equal COUNTIFS. COUNTIFS. First criteria range is all his names in column A. Press F4 and see if it's equal to Alan. And I press F4 one, two, three times to freeze just the column. Next criteria range is the colors in column B. Press F4 and then see if that's equal to red. Press F4 twice to freeze just to the row. And copy that throughout the data, and you're good to go. Now, that's if you're in Excel 2007. If you're not in Excel 2007, then we're going to have to rely on either an array formula or sum product. Sum product. Let's talk about sum product. So, equals sum product, and we're going to put two arrays here. We're going to multiply the arrays together, put each array in parentheses. So, an opening parenthesis, check to see if A2 to A21, again, press the F4 key, is equal to Alan, and press the F4 key three times. And then a multiplication sign, multiplication. And then we go check to see if everything in column B, press F4, is equal to red, press F4 twice. All right, so close that second array, close the whole sum product, and we're good. We can copy that throughout the data set. Okay, why the multiplication? The A2 to A22 equal to D3 is going to return an array of true and false values. And sum product can't deal with true and false values. It needs to deal with zeros and ones. So we need to coax that array of trues and falses into zeros and ones. Some people do that by putting a minus minus before the opening parentheses and another minus minus before this opening parentheses, separating both by a comma. I feel it's easier just to multiply those together. That, again, coaxes the trues and falses to change to zeros and ones, and it works just as well. There's a problem in Excel 2007 when you type a minus minus, they autocorrect that into an M dash. So, you know, for all you minus minus folks, the asterisk is going to work just as well and achieves the exact same thing. So, Sergio, thanks for sending in your question. Three different ways to go. If you just need a quick way to do it, the pivot table. If you need formulas that are going to keep it correct, COUNTIFS and Excel 2007, great way to go. Otherwise, you're going back to this relatively difficult sum product to solve the problem. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.